Thanks for joining us for CBN News Today. I'm Charlene Aaron.
And I'm Ephraim Graham. Some good news today for families of American troops serving in Afghanistan. President Obama says most of them will be coming home sooner than expected. The announcement comes as the president offers a new foreign policy focus, but it's reviving criticism. He's weakening America's standing in the world. Gary Lane has details.
President Obama laid out his plans for the Afghanistan troop drawdown at the White House Tuesday.
America's combat mission will be over by the end of this year. Starting next year, Afghans will be fully responsible for securing their country. American personnel will be in an advisory role. We will no longer patrol Afghan cities or towns, mountains or valleys. That is a task for the Afghan people.
America's 32,000 troops will be reduced to 9,800 by the end of this year. 5,000 will remain at the end of 2015. And only embassy guards will be present just before President Obama leaves office. The drawdown of troops to 9,800 by the end of this year is at the upper end of what U.S. generals have said is required to assist the Afghans. Meanwhile, the president is outlining a foreign policy vision for his remaining years in office. And during today's commencement address at West Point, it includes his view that American power is only part of a sustainable international system. Critics say U.S. foreign policy has lacked strong leadership and strategic thinking. They cite presidential indecisiveness in Syria and America's inability to prevent Russian annexation of Crimea. White House advisors have apparently held a number of briefings with members of Congress to address foreign policy concerns. But a Republican senator reportedly described one of the meetings as bizarre because specific answers to questions were never given. Tennessee Senator Bob Corker summed up his view of U.S. foreign policy, saying, quote, "One of the problems with the White House is that they view speeches as foreign policy. They don't really follow through with much in the way of substance. It's always minimal." But for now, the emphasis is on Afghanistan, America's longest-running war, one that President Obama inherited, one that he's determined to end, at least for the United States of America.
We have to recognize Afghanistan will not be a perfect place, and it is not America's responsibility to make it one.
Gary Lane, CBN News.
President Obama's top lawyer is investigating how the name of the CIA's top official in Afghanistan was accidentally leaked. The officer's name was sent out in an email to thousands of journalists when the president made a surprise Memorial Day visit to Afghanistan. The name was on a list of people who met with the president. The intentional disclosure of the name of a covert operative is a crime under the U.S. Intelligence Identities Protection Act.
The White House may increase its support for rebel forces in Syria trying to oust President Bashar Assad. With the Syria's bloody civil war now 3 years old, an anonymous member of the Obama administration says the president is considering a new program. It would send American troops to Jordan on a training mission. They would instruct selected members of the Free Syrian Army on a number of tactics, including counterterrorism operations. The president has not given his final approval of the initiative. The administration is still having internal discussions about the risks of increasing support.
New revelations on how VA clinics used strategies and tricks to hide delays in treating veterans. Some clinics scheduled fake appointments, kept unofficial logs, and made appointments without telling the patient. The, quote, gaming strategies were used to make it seem like the veterans were getting appointments within target times set by the Veterans Affairs Department. In Colorado, 500,000 veterans are still waiting for a hospital promised to them 10 years ago.
We kept our word. We served honorably. And in return,
I don't hate the VA. They got some of the greatest employees that give caregivers in the world. But their management, they got to change.
It's $500 million over budget, and 16 contractors are suing because the VA is not paying them. Meanwhile, Defense Secretary Chuck Hagel has ordered 90-day review of the military health care system.
Abortion providers in Wisconsin are trying to persuade a federal judge to strike down a law that requires them to have hospital admitting privileges. A federal judge blocked the law from taking effect after abortion providers filed suit last summer. They argue the mandate creates bureaucratic hurdles that will force some clinics to close. Supporters of the law say it will ensure that proper care is available if a woman develops complications during an abortion and has to be hospitalized. Preliminary hearings are being held this week, but the judge is not expected to make a decision for weeks.
Pennsylvania police are looking for the gunman who killed an unborn child. A pregnant 15-year-old girl was shot after opening the door of her Western Pennsylvania home on Monday. DeRay Delgado's mother says her daughter was 8 months pregnant and will survive, but her unborn baby was killed in the shooting. Police believe three people may have been involved in the attack, and they could be charged with murder. Pennsylvania is one of nearly 40 states with fetal homicide laws.
A pregnant woman was stoned to death by her own family outside a courtroom in Pakistan Wednesday. Farzana Parveen's father called her murder an honor killing because she married outside her family's will. Nearly 20 people attacked the 25-year-old and her husband in broad daylight, including her father, brothers, and her cousin, who was the man her father had chosen to be her husband. The Human Rights Commission of Pakistan reports that some 869 women were murdered in honor killings last year.
Political turmoil in Thailand as the country's military took control of the government earlier this month. But Thailand faces great social problems as well. It's home to the world's largest sex industry.
Each year, tens of thousands of tourists from around the world travel there to fulfill their fantasies. One Christian ministry in the heart of Bangkok is helping young prostitutes and tourists to find a way out. Lucille Talusan has this story.
At age 14, Mint quit school because her family did not have the money to support her studies. She wanted to escape poverty, so she left her rural home to work in Bangkok. But here, she met a man who got her pregnant.
After giving birth, I brought my son to the province. I went back to Bangkok to work in a massage parlor, but later on, I was enticed to go into prostitution because I needed the money.
But Mint had to bear the shame and face the danger that went with it.
I was always doing drugs and drinking. There was no way I can do the work without getting drunk first. One time, someone smothered my face with a pillow and tried to rape me. At that moment, I remembered someone told me I can pray to God, and so I cried to God to help me, and I survived that night.
A few months later, a Christian introduced her to Nightlight Ministry.
I experienced God's love when I came to Nightlight. We get to read the Bible and worship. He gave me a new life, and now I want to serve Him.
Nightlight rescues women and children trapped in the sex trade industry. It also trains women to support themselves by silk screen and jewelry making. Nightlight founder Annie Disselberg says prostitution and human trafficking have increased rapidly in Thailand since the ministry started in 2005.
Thailand has very good anti-trafficking laws, excellent, but it's very hard to enforce them. I hate to say it, but there's a lot of corruption.
Last year, Nightlight assisted 26 trafficked women, mostly from Uganda, to go home.
We know that God's heart is out there with these women. He longs for them to know that there is a way out.
Annie is grateful that CBN's Orphans Promise provided funds to remodel the Nightlight Outreach Center, turning the ground floor into a coffee shop.
This is the location of the City Light coffee shop that Orphans Promise helped build right at the heart of the red light district here in Bangkok. And as you can see, the location is very strategic because it is right in the middle of two bars. And through this coffee shop, the Nightlight Ministry, together with Orphans Promise, will be able to reach out to more women in prostitution and even the male sex tourists.
Men and women can come in off the street to get a good cup of coffee, and there will be people available who are willing to listen to their stories, to begin to build relationships with them. And out of those relationships, then we earn the right to speak into them, to give them hope.
The center is also used for prayer and worship, Christian parties, and medical clinics. A transformed Mint also helps in the outreach programs.
God has given me a burden for the women in the streets. I invite them to our parties where there's free food and I paint their nails. I share Christ with them to give them hope in their lives.
Together, Nightlight and Orphans Promise are giving more and more women like Mint a better opportunity for a new life. Lucille Talusan, CBN News, Bangkok.
Nigeria's leaders reportedly cannot agree on how to save those kidnapped schoolgirls. The country's military chief says a rescue operation is too dangerous and would get many of the hostages killed. Meanwhile, President Goodluck Jonathan is refusing to negotiate, turning down a demand to release prisoners in exchange for the girls. A community leader from the area where the girls were taken says the government is creating confusion by not speaking with one voice. Now, Boko Haram is suspected in two more attacks that killed more than 54 in northern Nigeria on Tuesday.
Coming up, it's a modern-day gold rush. A new generation of prospectors is finding fortune beneath the plains of North Dakota. See, the oil boom has transformed one state.
The American Bible Challenge is back. Premiering May 22nd at 8, 7 Central, Jeff Foxworthy is ready to play.
The whole family's gonna love it.
Kirk Franklin's gonna sway.
Are you ready?
And you'll see the Bible in a whole new way.
Don't I look chic?
That was impressive.
An all-new season premieres Thursday, May 22nd at 8, 7 Central, only on Game Show Network.
Pat Boone here with some good news you can trust. Today, our faith, families, and our freedoms are under attack. Polls say 2 out of 3 Americans no longer trust government. A stalled economy, weakening dollar, and politicians willing to steal money from our children to waste on unfixable problems. So, whom can you trust? Well, our money still says in God we trust. But do we? Or have we quietly allowed the things we hold sacred to be stolen by the enemies of traditional values? Today, our government spends almost twice its income, running up a tab for future generations into the hundreds of trillions. How can you stop this from happening to your family? Well, it's all covered in a fantastic new book, The Great Withdrawal, by Craig Smith and Dr. Lowell Ponte. Every American needs to read this book. Why don't you call now for a free copy of The Great Withdrawal? It's the simple truth you can trust.
The American Bible Challenge is back. Premiering May 22nd at 8, 7 Central, Jeff Foxworthy is ready to play.
The whole family's gonna love it.
Kirk Franklin's gonna sway.
Are you ready?
And you'll see the Bible in a whole new way.
Don't I look chic?
That was impressive.
An all-new season premieres Thursday, May 22nd at 8, 7 Central, only on Game Show Network.
Fighting urban blight could cost the city of Detroit up to $2 billion. That's the finding of a newly released report from the city's Blight Removal Task Force. It says a minimum of $850 million needs to be spent in the next 5 years, but warns that amount could easily climb to the $2 billion point. The task force says of the city's 840,000 parcels, nearly 85,000 are decaying, and some 40,000 structures need to be torn down immediately.
Well, when you think of North Dakota, you might not picture a land of prosperity, but that's exactly what it's becoming, thanks to a huge oil boom. David Brody shows us what's behind this boom.
History books tell us about the famous California gold rush in the 1800s when people headed west to strike it rich. Well, welcome to western North Dakota, where an oil rush is on for people like Curtis Hansel.
This is not a boom that's going to fizzle in 3 or 4 or 5 years. This is going to be a long time, a 30-year boom.
This big boom covers more than 200,000 square miles in the Bakken oil fields. Now, this isn't a Beverly Hillbilly strike because the oil is actually in underground rock. New drilling technology called fracking means that the roughly 170 billion barrels of crude oil can now be unearthed. Oil production has zoomed up 600% in the last 7 years, putting North Dakota as the second largest oil producing state in the nation, behind only Texas.
Well, we are here on an active oil rig in the Bakken oil fields of western North Dakota. There are about 180 or so oil rigs here in the state. And one reason many families are coming specifically here to the western part of the state is because of all of the economic possibilities.
In many oil operations, workers keep their family and home in another state. But in this case, many families choose to live here permanently. Curtis Hansel left his Utah real estate job and brought his family here 2 years ago.
I realized that this was an opportunity to get in on the cusp of something that I think will be good for us in the long run.
It's been good for the Hansel family and many others. The average oil worker out here makes $112,000. Beginners start at $66,000. And even those not in the oil business are making more. The population increase means more demand. So the local McDonald's and Walmart are hiring workers starting at $14 an hour. And many times, they add a healthy signing bonus just for agreeing to work there. On the other end of the scale, the number of North Dakota millionaires has climbed rapidly. Last year, the state ranked 43rd in millionaire households. Now, they're up to 29th on the list and climbing.
We have been able to live very comfortably, enjoy some things, for instance, vacations, those kinds of things, and still put a good chunk of money away for the future.
And there's more good economic news here. A staggering low 3% unemployment rate. 75,000 jobs created in the past few years, and a state economy growing at 5 times the national average. All of this has led to some growing pains, however. Dennis Johnson is mayor of Dickinson, a town where the oil boom has been a mixed blessing.
The majority of the people, probably somewhere around 60-70%, are positively impacted by the oil development. But there's probably a minority of 30-40% that it's a negative impact.
Take housing, for example. Demand is so great that 2-bedroom apartments that used to rent for $500, they're now going for close to $2,500.
It's increased our housing costs quite a bit. I feel sorry for people that don't have the big oil jobs.
And the increase in people has led to more crime, especially among the young single men hoping to strike it rich.
It's a scary place out here for women. And when girls come out here now, they think it's flattering like I did when I first got out here. And I very quickly reassure them that it's not, and they need to be very careful because these guys will, they'll take advantage of you.
There's no doubt this Bakken oil field area has challenges, but for Curtis Hansel and families like his, the positives surely outweigh the negatives.
If we do our part, that God will take care of us. And we've had to put that to the test a number of times, and so I don't want to make it sound like it's routine, but for my wife and I, it was just another challenge.
That challenge is proving fruitful for the thousands striking it rich in the oil fields of North Dakota. David Brody, CBN News, in Western North Dakota.
Up next, inviting God to the operating room. Meet the surgeons who pray and their patients who say they've seen amazing results.
Attention, sleep apnea patients. Are you tired of the expense and hassle of getting your CPAP and BiPAP supplies? Are you fed up with dealing with ill-fitting, leaking, or worn-out masks and straps? Are you worried about the effects that unsanitary tubes, cushions, and filters have on your health? If you said yes to any of these questions, Allied Medical Supply Network has the solution to your problems. You could qualify to have your supplies regularly delivered right to your door at little or no cost to you. That's right, no more inconvenience, no worn-out masks and straps, no more unsanitary equipment, just restful sleep. Call Allied Medical Supply Network today to determine if you may qualify to receive your fresh, brand-name supplies at little or no cost. Don't delay. Call us now to see if you are eligible to save money on regular delivery of your CPAP and BiPAP supplies. Call 1-800-815-9947. That's 1-800-815-9947. Or go to CPAPSupplyHelpline.com.
Announcing an important breakthrough in healthcare that can benefit everyone. If you or anyone you love needs affordable health insurance, regardless of a pre-existing medical condition, call Quick Insurance 123 today and get the immediate relief you deserve. Quick Insurance 123 was created to provide affordable health insurance to all uninsured Americans, with or without pre-existing conditions. This is not a discount card. This is a real insurance program that lets you choose from many affordable health plans. with access to doctors, hospitals, emergency services, and more. So call the number on your screen now and get the health coverage you need just for calling. As a special bonus, we'll send you a free prescription savings card that could save you up to 85% on your prescriptions. That's right. You could save up to 85% on your prescriptions just for calling. Call Quick Insurance 123 to find out how you can get affordable health insurance and receive your free prescription savings card just for calling. Don't wait. Getting a free quote is as easy as 123. Call today.
If you are facing an operation, you'd normally depend on your doctor for his surgical skills, and you'd look to a chaplain or your pastor for prayer.
Now, a growing number of surgeons are also praying with their patients before they operate. Paul Strand has that story.
It would be against his oath if Dallas heart surgeon Mark Poole didn't study every patient's case before operating. But he also feels it's against his calling if he doesn't at least offer to pray with them.
God is the great physician. He's the one that controls life and death.
Poole looks at the scalpel as his instrument during surgery.
In the same way, I see myself as an instrument in the hand of God. So I'm the one doing the operation, but he's the one guiding me.
We know about your love because you sent your son. We know about your power because you raised him from the dead.
And Poole wants to pray with his patients so they too can focus on that great physician.
When folks are facing medical emergencies, some people would say that's exactly the wrong time to pressure them about spiritual matters. But most patients say it actually takes much of the pressure off to bring God and prayer into their situations, and they appreciate it.
Take the case of Tom Pryor.
His risk of dying was probably 90% if he had no surgery. Even if you do an emergency surgery, the risk of dying is about 30%.
When Poole brought up praying,
I was slightly taken back for just a second, and then realizing my condition and the things that were going on, I thought it was probably a pretty good idea.
Pryor said Poole's prayers calmed and relaxed him, but was there a much bigger answer?
Yes, I am here.
Another praying surgeon, Rohan Jayaraja, says he understands a doctor offering to pray could make some patients uncomfortable and worried they can't refuse this powerful person.
To some degree, it can be like a teacher and a student, and you have to make sure that you're not overstepping your boundaries there or being inappropriate in that relationship.
The critics would say, well, there's a power differential. You're this powerful doctor, this poor patient's there, helpless, and they feel like if they say no, you might not do your best during the surgery or something like that.
I think it's important to be sensitive to the fact that there are patients, number one, who may not be Christian, and number two, who may not believe in God at all.
Still, Jayaraja says he's witnessed God do so much at his hospital, he can't help but believe and pray.
I see the hand of God every day. I always say that with the work that I do, it's almost like every day is going to church.
Poole, too, has seen miracles. For instance, with a patient whose heart just stopped one day.
And I opened his chest up, and I was squeezing his heart. Nothing was happening, and I prayed, Lord, save this man. We kept working, and within a few minutes, his heart started to beat. And there was nothing I had done differently to it. It just started up. And so his life was saved. He went home. He's doing great.
But not everyone wants contact with this spiritual world.
I have had one patient that turned me down. I was there, we're about to start the surgery. I said, would you mind if I say a prayer with you? He said, I prefer not.
Still, both Poole and Jayaraja's spiritual work gets almost 100% support from their patients.
Oftentimes they'll say, that prayer meant the world to us.
That's how Russell Truett felt after he had a heart attack, but waited about 3 weeks before going to the hospital.
Which is not the doctor's advice.
Poole did a double bypass on Truett, accompanied by lots of prayers.
It was a huge relief. Being a Christian, whenever he asked that, it just took the world of pressure off my chest.
CBN News talked with Jimmy Mayfield just before Poole replaced a valve in the 78-year-old's heart.
It makes me feel better to know that the guy that's going to make the decisions when he gets in there has the Lord with him and has that peace.
We pray that his operation would go smoothly.
Jayaraja says some people may think they wouldn't want these kind of prayers, but they probably haven't faced a killer disease yet.
At the moment that you find out that you've got some horrible disease, cancer, whatever, I don't care what you believe in. If you actively don't believe in God, you believe in God at that moment.
Truett encourages other doctors to follow Poole's and Jayaraja's example.
I think they would be surprised how many of their patients would appreciate it if they did do it.
1 Thessalonians says, pray without ceasing. And that definitely means pray before you go and operate.
These doctors are humble enough to admit they're not the great physician, but wise enough to say since they know him, it's a pretty smart decision to bring him into their surgeries. Paul Strand, CBN News, reporting from Texas Health Presbyterian in Dallas, Texas.
Isn't it awesome to see your surgeon quoting scripture and willing to pray with you?
I like that.
I do too.
Even if you don't pray with me, I like to have a praying physician in the room.
Amen.
Indeed.
That's a blessing.
All right, stay with us. We're coming right back.
Do you have an idea for an invention or a new product? Brian and Alice Jagosch, the inventors of the halftime drill driver, did. They invented a power drill attachment that lets you drill, flip, and drive in seconds. Brian and Alice licensed their invention to the company that brought you the Snuggie, and it's now selling in major retailers nationwide. Look for the Invent Help Caveman on the package. If you have an invention that you would like to try to patent and submit to companies for possible review and want free information on how InventHelp may be able to assist you, call now. InventHelp is America's largest inventor service company with sales offices in more than 60 cities nationwide. Call InventHelp today for free information. Our clients made a financial gain with their invention, but this is just their individual result. Brian and Alice's experience is not typical, as only a very small number of inventions are licensed or sold in stores.
For your free inventor's information, call 1-800-559-8567. That's 1-800-559-8567.
If you had a choice between going bald and a full head of hair, which would you choose? Advances in medical science have resulted in the world's first and only permanent solution to hair loss.
Yes!
You wash it, you cut it. It's your own real naturally growing hair. When it comes to hair restoration, no one in the world has more experience than Bosley. The results look completely natural and are affordable on nearly any budget. But the entire process can't be explained in 60 brief seconds. So to find out more about this clinically proven and permanent solution to hair loss, call now to receive your free no obligation information kit. It'll answer all of your questions about hair loss and hair restoration. Plus, we'll also send you this $250 gift certificate just for calling. Every day you wait, you're losing more hair. So don't put it off any longer. You owe it to yourself to find out the facts. Choose hair. Choose Bosley.
Call 800-868-9957. That's 800-868-9957.
Finally, two half-sisters have a lot of time to make up for.
Indeed they do, after recently learning they're related after 85 years apart. Zelda Gates and Rita Knight met for the very first time. The two share a dad, but were never told about each other. Zelda discovered her lost sister after reading her father's will.
I just wondered what he was like, and wonder how it's come he never tried to find mother, or mother didn't try to find him. I don't know what the connection was or what happened between them. I've often wondered, but I never did know. Mother never talked about it. And I asked, but she was rather evasive, so I didn't push it.
Well, I think it's wonderful. And we look so much alike. I mean, it's unbelievable.
No, I didn't say she looked like me. I just thought she looked good.
It's like looking in the mirror. Although the sisters do live in different states, they say they do look forward to building a relationship, one that will last indeed. They even kind of sound alike.
They do sound exactly indeed, alike, actually. Indeed. They look alike, too.
Nice reunion.
Awesome. Well, that's it for now on CBN News Today. You can find more of our exclusive coverage of the issues you care most about at cbnnews.com.
Take the time to tell us what you think about the stories you've seen here today. You can do it on Facebook or at CBN News on Twitter. Hope you join us again right here next time. Make it a wonderful Wednesday, everybody.
Inside every child is a hero, a leader, a friend to others, someone who helps out, who does the right thing, who dreams of what they can be, but they still need our help.
What should I do?
What should I say?
How should I feel?
That's where Superbook comes in. It provides moral and spiritual truths through situations children can relate to, teaching God's word to the children you love. Join the Superbook DVD Club and receive Superbook's newest episodes as they're available, plus two copies to share with others, all for your gift of only $25. Get Superbook today and watch the miracles happen.
Every day, people are connecting on Facebook, Twitter, and YouTube. Now you can be part of the conversation and connect on topics you care about through 700 Club Interactive. Log on to Facebook, Twitter, or go to YouTube and share your opinions, your prayer requests, and your videos while making friends in our community.
Well, welcome to the show.
Join the conversation on Facebook, Twitter, and YouTube. 700 Club Interactive. Be a part of the show.